Good morning, friends and strangers. I just realized that I forgot to turn my fans off. So if you can hear them in the background, I'm sorry with the morning I'm having. I'm not trying this again. It has been a series of unfortunate events. Technically and practically, everything keeps breaking or falling or etc. On top of that, I am my usual sick, but to a pretty extreme degree today. I hurt everywhere, and I feel like I didn't sleep at all. I took my medications, and it's just bringing it from a 10 to an 8. I really don't feel well. Very disoriented. Hard to think. And my discomfort in my body, I think, triggered a migraine. So I'm also having a migraine at the moment, on top of everything else. So I'm doing this to distract myself. It's amazing what people can adapt to when they don't have a choice. Like health problems that you didn't bring on yourself in any kind of way. This is my every morning. It's a bad every morning. But it's my every morning. So I just have to get used to it. I don't have a choice. Some things in life are unpleasant, and we don't have a choice. Things can change on a dime. Your whole life can be impacted. And you don't have a choice. But to adapt and accept it, eventually, because it's not gonna change. Because in order to be resilient, you have to be getting your ass kicked over and over and over and over again to be bouncing back from something. Some of life's struggles are very hard, and they will wear you out. It will wear you down. And sometimes we need to recollect and regroup ourselves and devote some real time to self-care, mental health care, physical health care, just to sustain. And it seems like the hits just keep coming. And resilience, you wish it wasn't your superpower, because, like I said, it's good to have resilience to be able to bounce back, but there's only so much stress and pain and damage and situations and trauma, etc., that a person can hold up before they psychologically or physically or physiologically, combination of psychologically and physically, snap. Everyone has a stress threshold, and stress, long-term stress, has real physical health implications besides just causing you to not be at your top performance. optimum performance in your life and in your relationships. Being under a constant barrage of life coming at you. But you don't have a choice sometimes. You wish it wasn't so, but it is. And you only have two options: to completely fall apart and give up, crumble to pieces, made a video about accepting reality as it is, having hot and cold flashes, and it's really disquieting. I'm a mess this morning, guys and gals, everyone else. If it's not gonna change, you have to adapt. You have to accept it, and you have to adapt. Regardless how obstinate, difficult, and unfair life can be sometimes. Sometimes for long times. I'm so tired of being resilient. That's okay. I know I'm resilient. I don't need to be taught anymore, universe. You've taught me enough resilience. I'm good at that skill. Let's give me something else to learn, something pleasant, so I can learn, like, gratitude and, you know, self-care, or something that's easier when things are easier. It's really easy to be happy when it's easy. It's easy to keep your head on straight, keep your actions and behaviors and relationships in check when you feel good physically, when your life situation is smooth and good. It's easy to be a leader. It's easy to be a good example of a human when your life is easy and good. It's difficult when it's difficult. Everybody reaches their threshold sooner or later. You have to regroup and attend to yourself. But anyone can keep their head on straight, make right choices, work on their attitude, function most effectively in life, drive their ship in the right direction. When life is happy, healthy, wealthy, and wise. Otherwise, when the shit hits the fan, especially when it hits it over and over and over again, when you are tested, when you are troubled, when you are sick, when you are in pain, when you are wounded, when you are lost, the list goes on. When you are down and out, that is when your coping skills count. And fulfill your obligations, your relationships, your duties, your health care, self-care, care for others, your adult responsibilities, that you can manage your life. When you are in the darkest of times, or handling long and continuous and chronic difficulty, it's not fair, it's not easy. Nothing in this life is guaranteed, and fair and easy are not guaranteed. Your situation can change on a dime, and you may be placed in a position of constant necessary resilience. I'd rather have it easy. Easier. Myself. Than have to have resilience be my superpower. I'm tired. Tired of feeling this way. Tired of getting knocked down. But life is not fair. Life is life. And you have to accept it on its terms. You cannot change it. We're not magic. We're not wizards. It is what it is. You have to adapt. And you can choose to lose your cool. To lose your mind. To lose your fortitude. To let it get you to such a state that you fall apart and allow your life to fall apart. Or you can choose to ride out the storm, still consciously captaining your ship, regardless of what and how long you're dealing with difficulty. Regardless how long the storm. It is in the storm that your emotional intelligence, your capacity to cope, really matters, and your character really shows. It's worth the fight. Even if you're tired of fighting, don't neglect self-care. Take care of yourself. Take time out for health and healing on all levels when you need it. Ask for help if you have it, for resources to take some load off when you need it. But don't give up the fight. Even if you're in a permanent situation that requires permanent resilience, a permanent negative change of course, like a change in your health. Because if you don't, you only make the situation worse for yourself. If you don't try to make the best of what is, regardless what it is, to take the wheel of your mind, take the wheel of your emotions, take the wheel of the situation, and continue to steer the ship in the right direction. Regardless how difficult it is. Otherwise, you will compound every problem by falling apart, lashing out, losing your cool, falling to pieces, and letting it all go asunder. Your ship will sink, your whole ship. If you don't steer it through the rough patches, even though it's not easy. It's easy to be happy, it's easy to be in control when things are easy. It's hard when it's hard, but it's imperative when it's hard in order to keep the rest of your life afloat and not sink your boat. Anyone can hold the helm when the sea is calm. It takes a true capacity of inner strength, fortitude, self-mastery, mindfulness, conscientiousness, and good character to be the best version of yourself possible, given difficult circumstances. Work on your attitude and continue to work on yourself and your life and live the best life possible, even when it seems impossible. Good morning, goodbye. Love you guys. Peace. I gotta do something with myself. Oh, girl. Good morning. Goodbye.